There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Woo! To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There is power.
Come on. Come on, you declare it.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
There is power
in the name. In
the Almighty God, who did what a man, the creator of heaven and earth, that was Zulu Nusha, is not for people as the Mohammed do. Of course.
Which was first announced by the Lord, was confirmed to us by those who heard him. Verse 4, God also testified to it by signs, wonders, and various miracles, and by gifts of the Holy Spirit distributed according to his will.
Say, Lord Jesus, I receive your word. Lisikelele, ekameni lenkosi uYesu. Signs and wonders of God.
Imimangaliso kaThixo.
The gospel that we have.
Eyona mfundiso bazalwane etshumayelo esinayo.
The Bible says it's accompanied by signs and miracles.
Ayibileke ithi soloko iphelekwa yimimangaliso.
There must be signs. God is God of wonders and miracles. Say amen. There are signs and wonders of God. God is God of miracles. The first miracle, it is you to be born again. When you are born again, that alone is a miracle in your life. That is why Nicodemus was confused when Jesus
Jesus spoke about to be born again. He said, how can one go back to his or her mother's womb? Because to be born again is a miracle. Say amen. We are a walking miracle. We are the walking and the living miracle. Because of Jesus who gave us a new life.
Who
was supposed to be right off. But God gave us a new life. We are also introduced into miracles. Salvation introduces people to miracles. The eye of a born again child is always looking miracles of the Lord. There is nowhere where a child of God is not in a miracle move. Glory to Jesus Christ. Even in times when our lives are in risk, a miracle is about to happen at any time. Why? Because we are children of miracles. Our God is God of miracles. From Genesis to Revelation, the Bible is full of God's miracles. Glory to Jesus Christ. Our eyes must be anointed to see miracles. When our eyes are anointed to see, the devil will never have any say in our lives. We must create again a platform of miracles. The miracles of the Lord. The devil has got his miracles. And God has his own miracles. Zangoma have got miracles. People have got miracles. But we are speaking to the miracles of the Lord. That is why the moment we are born again, we are no longer of ourselves. We belong to the Lord. So that he will demonstrate his power. Glory to Jesus Christ. The Bible says, we become to be in the hand of the Lord. The Bible says, those who are in the hand of the Lord, no one will snatch them away from him. Salvation takes us into the hand of God so that we see his wonders. Glory to Jesus Christ. As Christ the Lord, sons and daughters, we must create this platform. Everywhere you go, even if you are sleeping, expect a miracle of the Lord. Glory to Jesus Christ. A miracle is something that is beyond your thinking. You can't even do it. Only the supernatural power of God, it has done that powerful thing so that you glorify God. That is why it's important to be in the hand of God first. Glory to Jesus Christ. He is God of wonders. He also anointed his people to perform wonders in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Glory to Jesus Christ. When the children of God were leaving Egypt, They were introduced into the platform of wonders. When they were oppressed there, they knew Pharaoh as the man of miracles. They didn't know the power of God. Why? They grew there. The Bible says there was a time when the children of God were there in Egypt. During the time of old Pharaoh, they were led by Joseph when he was there. Because Joseph was there, sent by his brother, sold in fact, and he was made a leader there. Because he was a blessed man. The Bible says, when he was in prison, he was the interpreter of vision and dream. As a result of that, he was made in charge of Egypt. But the history says that Pharaoh died and a new Pharaoh was made. And this Pharaoh didn't know about Joseph. And they began to oppress the children of Israel. The Bible says, God came to Moses. Said, Moses, I have heard the cry of my people. I have come to redeem them. There was a strong debate between God and Moses. God said to Moses, I am sending you to Pharaoh. It was the first move to introduce the miracles of God. And Moses was afraid. He didn't know the miracles of the Lord. He was afraid of Pharaoh. That is why some of the people here are afraid of their enemies. They don't know the miracles of the Lord. But as from today, the Lord is going to perform miracles in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You won't know how you will be rescued. But what I know, the Lord will rescue your life. Glory to Jesus Christ. Glory to Jesus Christ. God said, what do you have in your hand? And then Moses said, it is just a rod. God said, throw it down. It turned into a snake. He didn't know that he is also a man of miracles. Because there are miracles of God. There are also miracles God has given to his people. That is why, if you are born again, you are not ordinary. There is something in you. There is something bigger than your understanding. And it's a time that we're going to throw it down. Glory to Jesus Christ. Glory to Jesus Christ. The Bible says, if handed it to a snake, you carry a better snake. I know some of you are scared of snakes. As I introduce the church into the miracle platform, there are snakes to be swallowed. The snakes of the moment shall be swallowed in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. You won't call some of my into your house. Something is in you. Something is in your head. No more fear. No more doubt, your God. Minding themselves.
Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. There is nothing better than what we have. No weapon is better than our weapon. Jesus in us is our last solution.
Thank you. Mambulise kubabukeli base South Africa uVuyandlo othethayo ndilapha kwazongqina obukhulu nobuhle bokwaThixo. UThixo ungimangazile empilweni yami kuyo yonke le minyaka edlulileyo endithwele sandigcinile. Lapha nje namhlanje ndisindisiwe ndihlangulwe ndiphilisiwe egameni likaYesu. Usathane uzamazamile ukundiwisa kodwa uThixo wala. Ndimile ke namhlanje ndizomisa ubungqina bokuthi uThixo uyaphila. UThixo ungincedile kwiinto ezininzi nasemsebenzini, wandinceda uThixo unyaka nonyaka nditshintshana nomsebenzi kungenxa yamandla akhe. Ndizokungqina ukuthi uThixo uyaphila. Izani bantu baseSouth Africa kuThixo ixesha lesavuma. Masizeni ke size kuThixo, uThixo azosiphakamisa, uThixo azosiphilisa, uThixo azosinceda. Akukho ubunzima uThixo ongakwaziyo ukusombulula, akho sifo uThixo ongakwaziyo usiphilisa. Ndibubungqina ke balololeyo, ndizophakamisa ke loo mazwi kuni ndithi uThixo undincedile kakhulu kwiinto ezininzi. Enkosi.
Molweni babukeli bakaBTV, ndingumama uMenerha ingandikhoze Christ the Rock. Umama omthanda kakhulu uThixo, kumnandi ukusinzwa bazalwana. Mna ndingumama owaselekelwa ngumyeni ekhulisa abantwana, kodwa uThixo uyahamba nawe ezintweni zonke. Akutshiwo uba ii-challenge azifiki kuwe, ziyafika ii-challenges, kodwa uThixo uhamba nathi siyaphumela ngoba sithembe yena. Kumandi uthembe uThixo, ungathembi abantu ngoba abantu baza kushiya, kodwa uThixo yena ulithemba lethu ngamaxesha onke. Nangeli xesha ndiyabakhuthaza amama abashiywe ngabalingane babo, bangashiyi ithemba, bangathemba abantu, baze kuThixo njengembali nomgqibeli sokholo lwethu. UThixo uThixo necebo, ungumthetheleli, udwawuxakwa uze kuye ngoba uthe ezweni lakhe, yizani kuni nonke nibuleleka imithwalo enisindayo ndiyaninokukuphumla. Ndiyanicela ke bonke abantu abanemithwalo baze kuye ngoba yena usikhathalele. Ndiyabonga ndiyabulela ngoba yena uhamba nami endleleni, abantwana bam sebekhona kodwa ndithembe yena. Iyabafihla iyabaphephisa imihla ngemihla, yena uthembakele ngoba uthe ezwini lakhe ungumalusi olungileyo. Uthi noba uhamba emfuleni wethunzi lokufa, yena ukhona, siyaphumela. Ndiyabonga ndiyabulela. Ndithe Nkosi baphulaphela ami.
Ndikhonza apha eChrist the Rock, ndifike 2014 ndandifike ndisahamba ukuthanda kwam, but uThixo wayinceda impilo yam. Ndiyabulela kakhulu oko ndafika apha, izinto ziyazenzekela ngegama likaYesu Kristu waseNazarethe. Shortly nje end July this year ndiye ndafumana iattack, ndahamba nayo lala esibhedlela ndivaleka ndingakwazi ukuphefumla ndingathi ndine-chest pains. But xa ndifika esibhedlela andabonwa ngugqirha ngalaa mini ndifika ngayo na the following day. Kwesithathu imini wafika ugqirha, wafika esithi ususpecta intliziyo, wazenza zonke iithesti. Uthe satsho ngenxa yemfundiso zalapha ekhaya, ndayiphikisa ndatsho kuye ndathi in Jesus name mna nayo i-heart attack. Wathi hayi, sawubona emagazini, sawubona kwiithesti eza kwenziwa. Wazenza zonke iithesti, waziphindaphinda inoba uziphindaphinde kathathu but engayifumani i-heart attack. Ndabe ndisithi mna andinayo i-heart attack, ndize nje ndizothatha ubungqini esibhedlela. Ndiyambulela kakhulu kuThixo waseChrist the Rock, ndiyazibulela imfundiso zaseChrist the Rock, imfundiso zikatata nomama. Ndiyabulela kakhulu ngegama likaYesu Kristu waseNazarethe. Ingase nomnye umntu obona ubungqina, obona amandla esiwafumanayo eChrist the Rock angake eze azozivela ngegama likaYesu
Thank you for supporting the ministry financially. God bless you kubo bonke laba who are always supporting monthly. It's not the waste of time. Apostle Paulo uthi, God that I serve will surely supply zonke izidingo zakho. Kulaba who are still praying to support, allow God to talk to you so that you do it with a revelation. It's not about money, it's about a revelation first. Why do you do it? So that we won't fix our eyes on money. It is about a revelation. But what I know, giving is a blessing to you who is the giver. The Bible says it is more blessed to give than to receive. If you want to support again, take our bank details. We will be blessed and you shall be blessed. God bless you.